Hello and welcome to the official channel of BOOX. One of our strongest suits has always been our reading function. Our built-in reader supports 17 different ebook formats, and you can take notes in any format directly in the reader and then log into the cloud to review the comments. Handwritten notes in PDF can also be incorporated, allowing you to open them on a computer and see all the annotations and notes. We've always been thrilled that our products help people read more effectively, but even if you're a long-term BOOX user, there are some setup suggestions you may not be aware of. So today, we'll look at 5 hidden gems as tips. The first tip is altering how BOOX are displayed in the library. Go to the library on our device first, where you can see all of the BOOX. Then you might be wondering, what if I want to find BOOX by looking through storage folders? Don't worry, you can switch between the two library display methods by clicking this button. When you select directory mode, you can see the folder in memory and navigate to find the book. Tip number 2, change how the books are scanned. On an Android reading device, the books will typically be kept in the books folder. You might, on the other hand, have a habit of downloading books or files from online pages. In this instance, the files may be saved to other locations, such as downloads. Then tap on the upper right corner, choose Library Settings, and click the Add button in Automatically Scan Specific Folders in the Storage to add the folder you want to scan. In this way, even if you put the book in a separate folder, it will still appear in the library and be easy to find. Tip number 3. Different devices can sync book annotations and handwritten notes. Our products range in size from 6 to 13 inches, and many users have multiple BOOX devices. We want to make reading on different devices as easy as possible for our users. So, since version 3.3.2 firmware, users can now sync their book notes by logging in to the same Onyx account. Because the devices only sync the notes and not the books, besides logging into the same Onyx account, you also need to place the same named book on the same path on both devices and enable synchronization to make the process run smoothly. So when you click the sync button on one device, you can see all of your notes, bookmarks, and font settings on another device, so you can read without stopping. Tip number 4, get the best refresh effect possible. When reading comic books or other books with a lot of pictures or dark colors, many people find that after images are left on some pages. And this will be more obvious with color e-paper. To fix this, click on the book, click Refresh in the upper right corner, and then go to the Refresh settings in our NeoReader. In the full Refresh options, select Regal Mode and Depth to offer the books a more comprehensive refresh and make it simpler to read with the fewest after images. Tip number 5. Change the touch area. Different devices have different grasping methods. Most individuals, for example, are accustomed to holding small gadgets with one hand, but large devices are more easily handled with both hands or on a desk. So, to make reading more immersive and consistent across devices, you can adjust the touch area to make it easier to turn pages and see the menu. Open a book, go to Settings in the upper right corner, and select Touch Settings. Then you can change how different touch areas work. For a small device, you can choose a unilateral area to turn the page up and down, which fits with how you usually hold it in one hand. Larger devices give you more room to make changes, so you can set it up to work the way you like. We showed 5 tips today, but there are many more treasures in our Library and NeoReader. What advice do you have for setting them up? Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section. I'm John from BOOX. See you next time.